I want it to zoom in. Yeah. I guess it is what it is. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to start 4-1. We're going to do all of 4-1 today. It has to do with radian and degree measure. Okay. So today we're going to learn about these radian and degrees. We're going to learn how to convert. We're going to kind of learn where they're located on the circle. So we are going to do the unit circle tomorrow. So tomorrow's lesson will only be the unit circle. All of you should have seen the unit circle before, okay? And you were tested on it last year. You were probably given a quiz where you were timed and you had to get them all right or you had to take it again, right? It's not really going to be the same experience this year, okay? So this year, we are going to take a quiz on it. It will be like 20 questions about the unit circle. You'll have to interpret the circle and answer the questions just like you did last year, but I won't be grading your circle. And if they're not all right, then they're not all right. Okay? So we're not going to take it over and over again. I will say, though, you have to know your unit circle. If you do not know your unit circle, you will not be able to find success for the rest of the year, because it comes up every single unit, the unit circle comes back. Okay, so once we see it, you have to know it. You really have to work on memorizing it and being able to evaluate it. You sure? Okay. So, ready to get started then? We're going to talk more about, we're going to briefly discuss it today, but very vaguely. Okay, so an angle has an initial side, and it also has a terminal side. That says terminal. And it's usually drawn in standard position. So if we take a look at this angle here, okay, this point is our vertex. And it's located at the origin. Okay, then we have our two sides. So this side is our terminal side. And this side is our initial side. The initial side is like where the angle starts. Okay, and it's always really at 0 degrees or 0 pi, depending on how you want to think about it, when it's drawn in standard position. Okay? Angles can be measured in degrees or radians. Radian measure requires the measure of the central angle of the circle. Okay, so we're going to draw a picture of what a radian looks like. So a radian, if you have one radian, is where our arc length, which is S, is equal to the radius. So remember that the radius of the circle goes from the center of the circle to the edge of the circle, right? And that if the radius is equal to the length of that intercepted arc here, of that piece of the circle, then this is equivalent to one radian. Okay, so one radian is, let's say when the radius R is equal to the intercepted arc length S. Okay, so hopefully you remember that the circumference of the circle is 2 pi r, okay? The central angle of one full counterclockwise revolution corresponds to the arc length of S equals 2 pi r. So again, just that circumference equaling 2 pi times the radius. Therefore, we know that 2 pi is equivalent to 360 degrees. Pi is equal to 180, pi over 2 is 90, pi over 4 is 45, and you can continue to break that down that way. Do you remember some of those numbers from last year? Okay. Also remember that pi is equal to 3.14, So 2 pi then is 6.28. So we can think about it like 6.28 radians around the circle, or 3.14 is our halfway mark. Okay, so you can break it down as a decimal as well. Because 2 pi is that full revolution and 2 pi is 6.28, it means that there are just over 6 radians in the circle itself. Okay, so today we're going to just look at some of these relationships kind of vaguely and hopefully make some connections about where these radian and degree measures are located on the circle. Okay, we're going to talk about some common angles that you learned about last year for the circle. So we're going to start out real easy. Okay, what is this measure right here? First of all, before we start there, think about it like a compass. Okay, right? We're going to talk about this a lot. North, east, south, and west. Remember, this is quadrant 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, and we're going to come back to those ideas as well. So, looking at, come on, come back here. Come on. Okay. All right. Well, looking at this, what is this degree measure? Zero or 360 degrees. Remember, it can be either one of those, right? In terms of a radian value, what is it? Zero or 2 pi, okay? How about at north? What is our radian measure? Pi over 2, very good. And degrees? 90 degrees. And then halfway around the circle at west, we would be at 180 degrees or pi, right? Because it's halfway around. We know a full revolution is 2 pi. At south, we're at 3 pi over 2 or 270 degrees. Remember, each quadrant is 90 degrees, right? We can break up the quadrant as well. So now let's just look in quadrant 1. If I was to cut this in half, then I would be here, and that would be like my 45 degree mark, right? In terms of a radian value, you could take pi over 2 and cut it in half, which is like saying pi over 2 times a half, giving us pi over 4. And then do you also remember that you can break up the quadrant into thirds as well, right? You could count by 30 degree increments, and so when you do that, you would get 30 degrees or pi over 6, and 60 degrees, and what's this one? Pi over 3. Okay, do you remember these numbers? Mm-hmm. Has anyone never seen any of this before? Anyone never see the unit circle before? Okay, that is good. Okay, so we're just going to locate some common angles. We've really already talked about them. We're just going to give their degree measure. So pi over 6 is equivalent to 30 degrees, and pi over 4, and pi over 3, pi over 2, pi, and 2 pi. Okay, that is good that Michaela knows what we're talking about. I hope the rest of you do as well. All right, so continuing on with this idea between radians and degrees. In order to figure out what one radian is equivalent to in terms of degrees, you can just take 360 degrees and divide it by 6.28 or 2 pi, right? Let's see, that gives us 57.3, I think. Yeah. So this is approximately 57.3 degrees. So this is one radian. Okay, this is an important number to remember. So if I were you, I'm going to try to maybe highlight the things that I think that you should probably memorize, I guess, in this chapter. I will say that there is a ton to memorize in this chapter. So it might help you to make note cards or, you know, make a list or highlight. I don't know. Whatever works for you, but there is a lot of memorizing. Okay, so based on the fact that one radian is equivalent to about 57.3 degrees, let's think about where these radians kind of fall along the circle. Okay? So looking at the circle down here, one radian, if it's 57.3 degrees, it's just going to be shy of that 60 degree mark, right? If we think about adding a second radian, it's like 57 plus 57 is going to take us to like what, 114.6, right? So maybe like here. If you think about the circle itself, if this is 0 or 2 pi or 6.28, doesn't that mean that over here is 3.14 because it's pi, right? And pi is equal to 3.14. So for 3 radians, you would just be shy of that halfway point. Imagine adding another 57 degrees or another radian value, you would be at 4 radians. Okay. And then if you added another, we would be at 5. And then finally, if you were to add that one more radian value taking you to 6, wouldn't you be just shy of that full revolution? Okay, so you might be asking yourself, why are we doing this? I am going to want you to be able, given either a degree or a radian measure, to figure out which quadrant that angle is. And it's so important for you to have like a really good understanding of where these fall on the circle. Okay, if you understand that, whether it's given in degrees or it's given in radians, you'll be able to not only answer those questions, but you'll also be able to interpret your own answers and your own solutions and check your work that way. Okay, so we are really trying to develop a good understanding of the circle, where last year I feel like you just were kind of introduced to it really briefly and then it just goes away. Okay, in terms of the four quadrants, again, this is quadrant 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we know that this is 0 or 2 pi, pi over 2, pi, 3 pi over 2. So where would theta lie if you were given these radian measures? So in quadrant 1, theta would have to be between 0 and pi over 2. In quadrant 2, it has to be between pi over 2 and pi. Quadrant 3, you're between pi, whoopsie, and 3 pi over 2. It's not equal to. Don't write that. And then in quadrant 4, you're between 3 pi over 2 and 2 pi. Okay, so if I gave you, let's say, 3 pi over 4, then you should be able to determine that that would be in quadrant 2, okay? So it's just going to be able to make those correlations, whether you're given a degree measure, you know, and you can, that's the easiest one, right? Like if I say 210 degrees, it's easier to figure out that that's in quadrant 3 than if I say, you know, 7 pi over 6. That's a little bit harder to think about. So you want to be able to convert between those two in your mind and locate the location on the circle. Everybody okay? Okay? Everybody kind of remember this stuff a little bit? Like this isn't totally new. So that's good. All right. So let's talk about coterminal angles next. Oh yeah, there's 4 pages of this lesson today. So coterminal angles have the same initial and terminal sides. So they're really just the same angle, but they have different representations. Like 0 and 2 pi, same angle, different ways to write them. Pi over 6, 13 pi over 6, again, the same angle, the same location, but a different representation. So there are actually infinite coterminal angles for each angle, because all you have to do is add or subtract a full revolution, which is 2 pi, to the angle. So if you want another representation of it, you add 2 pi, and you can add it again and again and again and so on. You can also subtract 2 pi to give you negative angles, okay? So if you want to find coterminal angles, all you have to do is add or subtract a full revolution, which is 2 pi. All right, we're going to try to do this. If we want to find one that is positive and one that is negative, all right, then all we have to do is add 2 pi. So in this chapter, you also have to be very comfortable with working with fractions, right? Because we're going to have to get lots of common denominators and be able to add and subtract those values. So looking at 2 pi here, in terms of a denominator of 4, what would we have for a full revolution? What is a full revolution with a denominator of 4? Isn't it 8 pi over 4, right? So we're going to take that 3 pi over 4, and we're going to add an 8 pi over 4. And when we do that, we get 11 pi over 4. So here is our positive coterminal angle. If we added another 2 pi over 4, we would be at 19 pi over 4. That's another coterminal angle, and so on. You just can keep adding and keep adding. If you want a negative representation, what do you think you have to do? Subtract. So I'm going to have 3 pi over 4 minus 8 pi over 4, giving me negative 5 pi over 4. In terms of B, if you start with a negative, okay, we're still going to do the same thing. We're going to add a full revolution. If we weren't to a positive angle at that point, you would just add it again, okay? So you can keep adding it over and over and over again. So if I take negative 2 pi over 3, a full revolution with a denominator of 3 would be 6 pi over 3, which represents 2 pi. Okay, so when I add that, I get 4 pi over 3 for my positive. And then my negative would be?
Negative 8.
Yep, negative 8 pi over 3. You're just subtracting that full revolution. Any questions about coterminal angles or how to find them? Okay, great. Moving on. This is going to take you back to your geometry days, so that'll be a fun visit, okay? Complementary angles and supplementary angles, you remember those? Complementary angles have a sum of pi over 2, or a sum of 90 degrees. Supplementary angles have a sum of pi or 180 degrees. Okay, these are definitely 2 things that you need to memorize. So you need to know the difference between complementary and supplementary. I taught geometry for a long, long time, and students would always have a hard time remembering which went with which, that complementary added to 90 and supplementary added to 180. But there is an easy way to remember it. It's really just alphabetical order. Like, if you think about alphabetical order and number order, then it makes sense what goes together, right? Because C comes before S, just like 90 comes before 180. So 90 and complementary go together, and supplementary and 180 go together. So if you have trouble remembering it, think about alphabetical order, okay? Angles that are greater than 90 degrees or greater than pi over 2 cannot have a complement, right? Like, you can't get 2 angles that'll add to 90 if one is already over 90. Makes sense, doesn't it? So sometimes it's not possible to get a complement, okay? So we're going to try to find that now. So think about that. Go back to your geometry days. How did you find the complement of an angle if you were given one of the angles? Dirk? Yeah, just subtract it from 90. So if we're given it in terms of pi, then don't we just subtract it from pi over 2? Okay. So here we'll do complement and we'll do supplement over here. So for the complement, I'm going to take pi over 2 and I'm going to subtract 2 pi over 5. Now I have to have a common denominator to do that. So what is the common denominator? 10. So this is going to give me 5 pi over 10. Minus, what is that, 4 pi over 10? So pi over 10 is my complement here. In order to check that, you could just take pi over 10 and add it to 2 pi over 5. you should get pi over 2. How do you figure out the supplement? Yep, subtract it from pi. So pi minus 2 pi over 5. My common denominator would be 5. So I'd have 5 pi over 5 minus 2 pi over 5, giving me 3 pi over 5. You can, but it's going to take you a lot longer. I mean, that's just another step. So if it's given in radian measure, then you have to give your answer in radian measure. So it's not like you could just say what degree that was. Okay? Look at B. If I take pi over 2, and I'm trying to find the complement of 4 pi over 5, what's going to happen? Any thoughts? I'm going to get 5 pi over 10 minus 8 pi over 10, right? Which is negative 3 pi over 10. Why is it negative? Because this was greater than pi over 2 to begin with. Okay? So because of that, this can't have a complement. So if you get a negative, there's no complement. Okay? Now, hopefully, once we kind of do the unit circle and you become more comfortable with it, you would have recognized that from the very beginning, right? That 4 over 5 is greater than a half, right? So if it's greater than a half to begin with, then you can't have a complement. To figure out the supplement, though, we're just going to take 5 pi over 5 and subtract 4 pi over 5, giving me pi over 5. So far, so good? Now, we've only worked with radians so far. Radians are harder to work with than degrees, right? We're all more comfortable with degree measure. So if I want to find a coterminal angle for 114 degrees, what do I have to do? Yep, add 360 to it. So that's going to take me to 474 degrees. Make sure you have a degree symbol there. How do I find the negative representation? Just subtract 360, which gives me, what's that? Negative 246. And again, you're talking about degree measure there. To find the complement in the supplement of a degree, what do I have to do? Yep, take 90 and subtract the given angle. So I get 3 degrees. To find the supplement, I should subtract it from 180. So you can do this regardless if you're given radians or degrees. Okay, degrees are just easier. Same thing here. When we find the complement of 167 degrees, is it possible? No, because it's already greater than 90 degrees to begin with. So there is no complement for 167 degrees. No, you don't have to show your work. You can just say none. And then for the supplement, we're just going to do 180 minus that 167, giving us 13 degrees. So far, so good? Moving on. Okay, now we're going to convert between radians and degrees by hand. So you can remember these two formulas, or you can just memorize this generic formula, which works for either one of them. I would recommend this one. It's just one formula, right? And it works for everything. So you need to know what the pieces represent. N is the number of degrees. And theta is your radians. Okay, and then 180 and pi are just constant. They're always there. Okay, those don't change. Another thing that is super important to understand is that units matter so much in this chapter. So if you're talking about degrees, you have to write the degree symbol. If you're saying 10 degrees and you don't write the degree symbol, and you just write 10, then what you're telling me is 10 radians. Now, 10 radians is equivalent to 573 degrees, where 10 degrees is quite different than 573 degrees. You see what I'm saying here? Radians is implied if there's no unit. Okay, so if you just see pi over 2 or a 5, that's radian measure. If it says a degree symbol afterwards, well, then you're talking about degrees. So it's really important that you not only know how to read that, but that you also give that unit a measure where necessary. Okay? So let's try this. Let's convert. So in order to convert this by hand, we're just going to plug it into the formula. So I'm given degrees. I'm converting it to radians. So I'm going to have 135 over 180 equals theta over pi. When you convert to radians, you're always going to keep your answer in terms of pi. Okay? So in order to solve for theta here, you just have to multiply by pi, correct? So theta equals 135 pi over 180. And then you want to simplify that. I'm assuming that you all know how to use the graphing calculator to simplify a fraction, but just in case, let's take a look. So if I type in, I really need this to show. Nick, will you turn on the light and see if that will help? And nothing. I don't know why this is doing this today. I won't be able to see it. Okay, let's see. I am recording, but it's all right. It's just going to be what it's going to be. Okay, so let's do 135 divided by 180. And then in order to change that to a fraction, all you have to do is math and then option 1. I think everyone knows how to do that, I hope. Did you know how to do that on the calculator? Okay, good. So anyway, we get 3 pi over 4. Okay, so you want to simplify your fractions. So this is 3 pi over 4 radians. Now, once we talk about the unit circle, hopefully you'll recognize that because 135 degrees is a unit circle measure. So after tomorrow, you should be able to do that in your head. Okay? Negative 270 degrees, we're going to do the same thing. In order to convert by hand, we're going to use our formula. So we're going to do negative 270 over 180 equals theta over pi. We're going to multiply by pi, giving us negative 270 pi over 180. Those are both divisible by 90, right? So you get negative 3 pi over 2, which again is a unit circle value. Okay, after tomorrow, hopefully, you'll recognize that. I'm really building up tomorrow. It's so much fun. This lesson is going to be so much fun. We're even going to get to color. Like, it's awesome. Super fun. So just get ready, okay? Now we're going to convert to degrees. So now we're going to go the opposite way. Now, do you see how it says, radians, R-A-D? It's not going to say that. Okay, I don't know why I put that in the notes, honestly, but I want you to recognize that it's radian measure, but when it's given in the book or when I give it in the future, it's not going to say radians afterwards, okay? How would you know or how would... Right, there's no degree symbol, so it's implied, but I don't know why I wrote it. Anyhow, we're going to convert, so we're going to do n over 180 equals theta, which is negative pi over 2, all over pi. Okay, now for this one, remember that dividing by pi is the same as multiplying by 1 over pi, right? Multiplying by the reciprocal. So this is really like saying times 1 over pi, which means that when you take negative pi over 2 and you multiply by 1 over pi, don't you just get negative 1 half? So n over 180 equals negative 1 half. Okay? Then we're going to multiply both sides by 180. So this is going to give us n equals negative 90. Agree? And we just converted to degrees, so we have degree measure. Another unit circle value. Okay, if it just said 2, pretend like this is in here. So if this rad wasn't here and it just said 2, you need to recognize that that's 2 radians, okay? So we're going to type that in. Well, I'm not going to really type it in, but we're going to write that into our formula. So n over 180 equals 2 over pi. We're going to multiply by 180, and we're going to get 360 over pi. Now, when we give a degree answer, it doesn't make sense to leave our answer in terms of pi. So we would never say 360 divided by pi degrees. That's dumb. Okay? Just do 360 divided by pi. Everybody know where the pi key is on the calculator? It's above the little caret, so you hit second caret, well, after you hit divide. Okay, so 360 divided by pi, we should get 114.59 degrees. Actually, 592 degrees. We're going to round to the thousandth, just as we have on everything else, okay? So we're going to keep on with that. Now, the calculator will do all of this for us, okay? On the next quiz and test, you're going to get to use your graphing calculator, but I'm going to ask you to do some of it by hand, showing the formula. I'm going to ask you to do some of it on the calculator. I will not help you with your calculator during the quiz or the test. You have to know how to use it. So, last chapter, a few people started asking, does it matter what mode I'm in? Do I have to be in radians? Do I have to be in degrees? So you must remember that from last year a little bit, right? Like where you had to choose the mode in the calculator, which is so important, okay? You have to know what mode to be in. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're all going to reset our calculators just like we would on the day of a quiz or the test, because you're going to have to know how to choose the mode. So second plus 712, go ahead and reset it. In order to evaluate anything on the calculator, the rule is that whatever type of answer you're looking for is the mode your calculator should be in. So if you're looking for a degree answer, then you should be in degree mode. If you're looking for a radian answer, then you should be in radian mode. Okay? It's a good rule to follow. I would write that down if I were you. Okay? So whatever answer we are looking for is the mode we should be in. So, in example 3, I'm trying to convert 108 degrees into radians. So I'm looking for a radian answer, so I need to be in radian mode. So in order to change the mode, you have to go to the mode key. Interesting idea, okay? And if you arrow down to that third line, you'll see radians and degrees. Whichever one is highlighted is the mode you're in. So we want radians, which is the factory setting, so we're set. We can go ahead and quit out of that. You will be changing the mode several times during a quiz or a test or your homework. So it's really important you think about that first thing, is what mode is my calculator in, okay? So now what you do is you type in 108 degrees. So type in 108, and then there is an angle menu. If you go to second apps, which is that purple key, and you open up that angle menu, it is the first option. It is option number 1, so you're just going to hit enter. Now, we've already told the calculator we wanted a radian answer, so when we hit enter the second time, it will give us a radian answer. So this is where I'm saying knowing your circle and how to convert is so important, because when we use the calculator, sometimes you're going to question, like, did I do that right? Does that answer make sense? I hope you question that. Like, you need to ask yourself, does my answer make sense in this situation? So I'm going from 108 degrees, and I'm now getting 1.885 radians. Does that make sense? Well, if you think about where 108 degrees is lying on the circle, let's look at it down here. Isn't that over 90, right? And I got an answer that was less than 2 radians. So it kind of makes sense that those two would go together, okay? So I just quickly think about the circle. Does that make sense? It only takes a second, but it's a good way to verify your work. So 1.885 is our answer. Now, we don't have to write R or radians afterwards. It's implied. So don't write that. You just write 1.885. To convert from radians to degrees, now what mode do I need to be in? Degree. So I go back into the mode. I choose degree. I quit out of that. And now I have to type in 2.3 radians. So 2.3, go back into the angle menu, and then there is an option R, okay, which is the third option. That stands for radians. Hit enter. Now when I hit enter, I should be getting a degree answer. Does 2.3 radians correspond with 131 degrees? It does. Like if we go back to our little chart here, over 2 radians should be, you know, almost that halfway mark, which would be 135 degrees. So it's making sense that we're right, almost right there. Okay? So 131.780 degrees. Why don't you try, let's say, go ahead and try those real quick. Now, remember that option I showed you the other day, if you hit second enter, if we hit it twice, then that 108 degrees will come up, and we can just arrow over and edit that. So if you hit second enter on the calculator, it'll keep recalling what you put in, and then you can just edit that. It's quicker than having to retype it in every time. So just 213, hit enter, but I never changed what? I never changed my mode, right? Right now I'm in degree mode, so if I type in 213 degrees, I should get 213 degrees. So I need to go back in, change the mode to radian, and then try it again. 3.718. Okay, so you type those in and see if you can get these answers. Were you able to get these solutions? Everybody comfortable with using the calculator to convert to radians? Okay, now let's go the other way. So now we're going to go 2 degrees. In order to do that, when you type this in, you need to tell it that it's radians. So you need to put parentheses around this 5 pi over 4. And you have to type in the little r as well. And we have to be in degree mode. And then see if you can get these solutions. I got 225 degrees and 257.14. Everybody able to get that? The parentheses are absolutely imperative to getting that solution there. What happened? Oh, it is? Okay, thanks. Better? Okay, everybody okay on that? Converting to degree measure. Moving on. So degrees can actually be broken down even further, and then that is called degrees, minutes, and seconds. And this is used a lot in navigation, so pilots or latitude and longitude, locations on maps, things like that, where you need an exact pinpointed location. This is a more exact answer. So 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So therefore, 1 degree is equivalent to 3,600 seconds. Okay, the symbols, we know the degree symbol, okay, but the minute symbol is just like an apostrophe, and then the second symbol is like a double apostrophe or half a quotation. So if you wanted to change this by hand, then what we would want to do is we would want to compare it so that we were comparing every single one of these measurements to 1 degree. So this 42 degrees, we could just put over 1, right? Because that's like 1 degree. Then we would add 17 minutes over 60 minutes because 60 minutes is equivalent to 1 degree. Then we would have to add 5 seconds over 3,600 seconds because 3,600 seconds is equivalent to 1 degree. So all of our denominators represent the same unit of measure. Okay? So then how would you have to add these together? Deck? Why would you? Why wouldn't you? Well, essentially, that's what we're doing here when we're adding this all together. Okay, so now we'd have to get a common denominator, right? We would have to change all those. We'd have to add the numerators. Okay, fine, whatever. Anyhow, we get 42.2.85 degrees. Okay? Well, you got to get a common denominator first, right, in order to add fractions? You're saying in the calculator? Yeah, you could. But the even better part is that we actually don't have to do any of this. Calculator will do it for us. Okay? And we're going to use the calculator. So we actually don't have to convert by hand. But you do need to know how to use your calculator. So we're going to do the same thing, but in the calculator. So we're taking this degree, minutes, and seconds answer, and we're just going to convert it to a degree answer in terms of a decimal. Okay? So that means that I'm going to a degree answer, so I need to be in what mode?
Degrees.
Degree mode. So verify that you're in degree mode. And then we have to learn how to type this in. So we're going to do 42 degrees. We know where to find the degree symbol, right? You just go into the angle menu. 17 minutes we can type in using the angle menu. That is option 2. But now the seconds is not in the angle menu. So type in your 5 and then do alpha plus. Alpha is the green key and then the addition symbol plus. And you'll see that second symbol come up. Okay? Hit enter. And that's our decimal equivalent, which is the same thing we just converted above. Okay? So we get 42.285 degrees. Much faster than having to convert it by hand. Okay? Now, you try B. Remember that you can do second enter to recall the last thing you typed in, and then you could edit that one if you wanted to save time. Okay? This says negative 20 degrees and 6 seconds. Are you getting an error?
Yeah.
Why do you think you're getting an error?
Negative.
Not because it's negative, because you can have negative angle measure.
You don't have 0 minutes.
Yes. You have to have a placeholder here. So there is no minutes. You have to put in the placeholder in the calculator. So you really have to type in negative 20 degrees, 0 minutes, and 6 seconds. Now try it. Were you able to get an answer?
Yeah.
Negative 20.002 degrees. Okay, everybody okay with how to use the degrees, minutes, seconds idea here? How to enter it and convert it to a decimal value. Now we're going to go backwards. We're going to be given a decimal value in either degrees or radians, and we're going to convert to DMS. So now what you're going to do is 315.8. Okay, now we're still looking for a degree answer, so we can still be in degree mode. And then we're going to choose degrees. And now we want to go in to the angle menu again and choose the DMS option, which is option 4. And hit enter. and we get 315 degrees, 48 minutes. Do not write 0 seconds. Okay? Look at C. What do you think you have to type in for C? There's a little R here. You have to type in the R. You have to tell it, now I'm entering a radian measure, but I still want degrees, minutes, and seconds. So I still want a degree answer. So 3.7. Before you type this in, what kind of degree value do you think you should get? Like, where should we be at 3.7 radians? Somewhere, is it going to be above or below 180?
It's going to be above.
Above 180, above. Right? Not a lot, but some. So let's go ahead and see if we get an answer like that. And we're going to DMS, so option 4. And that looks good. 211 degrees, 59 minutes, 39.783 seconds. Yes.
Above.
Above. Oh, I see what you're saying in terms of like the location on the circle. Yeah, I'm saying it's greater than 180 degrees. Maybe that's a better use of words. Okay. Last idea. Because I'm still looking for a degree answer.
Okay.
So even though I was given radians, whatever answer we want, that's the mode we're choosing.
How does seconds fit into a circle?
It's breaking down that degree further and further and further, just into smaller increments. Not to some people. All right, so finding arc length. This is the last thing we're going to talk about. So you can find the length of that intercepted arc, okay? You need to be given a radius and the central angle of the intercepted arc that you're looking for in order to do so. The really important part here to know is that you have to use radians. To find S. For the sake of time, we're not going to really look at deriving the formula. We're just going to cut to the formula. So S equals theta times R. And this is another thing that you have to memorize. So S is the intercepted arc length. R is the radius, and theta is your radian measure. Okay, so find the length of the arc if the radius is 4 and the central angle is 160 degrees. Can you just plug 160 degrees in for theta? No, because it says you have to use radians. So what do we have to do first?
Convert.
So I'm going to take 160 and I'm going to convert it using the formula that we practiced. You could use the calculator to do this, but we're just going to use the formula. It's equally as quick. Right? So 160 over 8 or 180 equals theta over pi. When you multiply by pi and you simplify, you should get theta equals 8 pi over 9. Okay, so now I know theta. I know that R was 4, and I can just substitute it into the formula. So S equals 8 pi over 9 times 4, which is 32 pi over 9. But that doesn't make sense for really an answer unless it says to keep it in terms of pi, which it does not in this case. So just evaluate 32 pi divided by 9. And I don't have this written down, so what is it? Mm-hmm, 11.170, and that should be centimeters. right?